In this video, I'm going to be talking about the best neighborhoods in Naples, Florida. So, if you're thinking about moving to Naples and you want to know the best places to live around here, stay tuned. Guys, it's your Southwest Florida real estate expert, Chloe Shook. And in today's video, we're going to be talking about the best places to live in Naples, Florida. Now, some people like the beach, some people like to golf, and some people like to stay active. And depending on what you're into, there's going to be a different neighborhood or community that suits you best. So this video is really going to be more of a breakdown of different areas to live in Naples and what might appeal to people based on what they like to do. But really, the best way for me to help you is if you're thinking about moving here, give me a call. We'll talk about what you're looking for in the place that you live, what your budget is, what you like to do, and we can narrow it down from there to figure out what place in Naples might be best for you. So please don't be shy. I love when you guys reach out to me. Give me a call, text, email. I'd love to hear from you. So unlike other major cities that have the downtown area and then suburbs of that city, Naples isn't really set up like that. So out of the 22,000 square miles that is Collier County, Naples only occupies about 16 square miles. And then other than Marco Island and Everglades City, the rest of Collier County is unincorporated and referred to as Naples. So the term Naples and Collier County are used somewhat interchangeably. And since there's no suburbs, people either describe a location in Naples based on the roadways it's next to, or based on the specific community or neighborhood as if that were a suburb or a small city. So let's say you want to be right on the beach. The area that you're going to be looking at is west of US Highway 41, or as it's also called, Tamiami Trail. Living in this area means that you'll be close to everything that Naples has to offer. And since this is the most desirable area to live in Naples, it's also the most expensive. A high-rise luxury condo will cost you between $2 and $5 million. Houses in this area range from $5 million all the way up to $60 million. Some key neighborhoods in this area include Port Royal, Pelican Bay, Park Shore, The Moorings, and Old Naples, just to name a few. And if you're interested in having direct golf access, this is the place in Naples that you're gonna wanna live. So heading further east, we have the area between Tamiami Trail and Goodlett Frank Road. Some notable neighborhoods in here include Pine Ridge and Lake Park. Now, neither of these communities have an HOA or any kind of shared amenities. They're about 5 to 10 minutes from the beach, depending on what part of the neighborhood you live in. And they're still pretty close to all of the shopping, restaurants, and things to do that we talked about. Most of these homes sit on about over an acre of land, which is really rare to have that much land this close to the beach. These are more traditional style single family homes, and they range anywhere from $2 to $10 million. Moving further south, we get into the Naples redevelopment area, which is close to downtown. Over here, we've got a lot of new construction, mostly condos and villas, but some single family homes. One of the more popular communities is called Bayfront. Now, this is a mixed-use development, so you've got retail and office spaces on the first floor and living spaces above that. The community has a pool, clubhouse, and a fitness facility. One of these units will cost anywhere from $1 to $5 million, depending on the size. Between Goodlett Frank and Airport Pulling Road, you've got quite a few condo communities. On the more affordable end of the spectrum, we've got Naples Bath and Tennis, Pine Woods, and Turtle Lake. These are located more towards the northeast corner of this chunk of property. Now, these condos were built in the 70s, so they're not super modern. They don't have a ton of amenities, but you're still only about 15 to 20 minutes from the beach. Plus, you're close to the grocery store, Target, Walmart, Publix, and other movie theaters, shops, restaurants. It's still a good location. And you can get one of these units for anywhere from $300,000 to $400,000. Another community located in this section of Naples is the Wilderness Country Club community. Now, if you buy a home in this community, you are required to also purchase an unlimited golf membership. This community also has several other amenities, such as 5 resort-style pools, a restaurant, tennis courts, bocce ball, a dog park, and more. Now, this is what people in Naples call resort-style living. Everything is right there in the community. If you're looking to get a home in this neighborhood, they range anywhere from $300,000 up to $1.1 million, just depending on the size and whether or not they've been renovated. Now, between Airport Pulling Road and I-75, you've got even more of these resort-style communities. Name a few. We've got Glen Eagle, Gray Oaks, Kingsdale Gardens, and more. A lot of these communities were built in the early 2000s, so they've got mature landscaping, but they're also fairly modern. So heading east of I-75 and north of Vanderbilt Beach Road, you've got more of these resort-style communities. Now, these are about a 30-minute drive from the beach, so because of that, there's a little less demand for them, making them a little bit more affordable. So if the amenities are the most important thing to you, this might be the right spot. All right, so east of I-75, but south of Pine Ridge Road, we've got a community called Golden Gate. Now, this is a bit more of a rural area of Naples. Each lot is about an acre, and they are on a well and septic system as opposed to public utilities. Most of these homes were built in the 70s and 80s, but you also see a lot of new construction over here, specifically people who are buying a lot to build a custom home. So there's really quite a range, between what you can get in Golden Gate, but it's definitely a more private style of living. So if you want to be a little bit further from all the noise, then this might be a good place for you. All right, the last area of Naples I wanted to talk about is what's referred to as East Naples. This is the southeast portion of Naples that runs right along Tamiami Trail. Now over here, you'll find even more of these resort style communities, such as the Isles of Collier County, Lely, Verona Walk, Treviso Bay, just to name a few. So living in East Naples, you're only about 15 minutes from the beach and downtown Naples. Plus you're close to Celebration Park and Tin City, but if you wanted to go to Mercado or Waterside, those would be about 25 to 30 minutes. But these communities have some of the best amenities because they're fairly new, they keep them very up to date, they're very well manicured, and your money does go a little bit further out here than it would, further north in Naples. Now, most of these are gated communities with a mix of different amenities. Some have golf, some don't, but they are all very nice places to live, and most of them are under $1 million. So that's basically an overview of how Naples is set up and some of the best places to live around here. If you want to know more about living in Southwest Florida, best places to eat, places to shop, things to do, best neighborhoods, make sure you subscribe to my channel and tap the notification bell so that you can stay updated. Now, it's impossible to cover everything in a short video about Naples. So if you're really interested in moving here and you want to know more about buying real estate and what might be the best fit for you, please feel free to give me a call, send me a text, shoot me an email. I would love to help you in your home search. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.